Good morning, sophomores. I'm Jeremiah. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And this is Coach Slaughter. So what are the current sports going on during the fall season?
So right now we have girls golf, girls tennis, boys and girls swim, boys and girls cross country, volleyball, football, and cheer.
Are there any COVID regulations for the season at South Florence?
Just like anywhere else, there are going to be COVID regulations for us to participate. So right now, all of our fall sports are in their regular seasons, which means that their groups can be pretty large. But within that, they do have to maintain social distancing. They do have to wear a mask when they're not actively participating. They're not allowed to drink from shared water sources, so they have to bring their own water bottle to every practice and refill it at different water stations.
Does it cost to attend a football game in Morehead Stadium this year? How many people can attend?
Sure, so $7 admission to get into the football games at Memorial Stadium. Right now, we have been approved for 3,500 capacity. We do have to subtract some spectators from that number due to like our band and gate workers and workers inside the stadium.
What's the most exciting part about coming to South Florence?
Okay, there were many. One of which was just, you know, getting to know new students and seeing how they like to compete and learn a little bit about them as people. And then just the passion and the love for athletics in South Florence by the community has been a big draw.
What sporting events have happened this week?
So earlier this week, we had cross country participate in a meet at Lake City High School. They won both of those meets in their boys. We had three out of the top five placers in that one. And our girls, we had five out of the top five. So very impressive by them. Volleyball participated in a match on Tuesday as well at Sumter High School. They won that one 3-0. And then just last night, our tennis team played against Wilson High School and finished that match with a 6-1 victory. They are now 3-0 on the season. And volleyball traveled to North Myrtle Beach, and they actually lost that one, but fought really hard to try and win it.
What are the sporting events for next week?
Okay, so on Tuesday night, we have cross country at a meet at Marion. Our volleyball team will have their first home match of the year against Darlington. Wednesday, swim is at the Country Club of South Carolina for their first meet. Thursday, volleyball is home versus Wilson. Women's golf will play at Darlington. And women's tennis will be at Myrtle Beach. And then next Friday, our varsity football team kicks the season off with their first game-like scrimmage at Sumter High School.
Thank you, Coach Slaughter.
No problem.
Good morning, South Florence. I hope you have had a great first week and are off to a fantastic start to the school year. If I haven't had the opportunity to meet you yet, my name is Shan Josie, and I am excited to be joining you this year as your new principal. Your administrative team, along with your teachers, are here to support you in any way that we can. Don't hesitate to reach out to us should you need assistance with anything this year. Although this year isn't starting out like a normal school year, I want to take this opportunity to tell you that everyone at South Florence on our faculty and staff is committed to making this year a great one. Our student clubs and organizations will be active this year. We will have virtual sessions and in-person clubs. So please be on the lookout for opportunities for you to become an active member in some of our organizations. The more involved you are, the better your high school experience will be. We are excited about our athletics getting started. I know Coach Slaughter shared with you some of our highlights. I do want to congratulate the tennis team on their fantastic 3-0 start and our volleyball team on their victory over Sumter last night. So congratulations to all of our Lady Bruins, and we look forward to seeing you supporting our athletes very soon. I'm sure you have noticed our football team on the practice field every afternoon preparing for their first game. The Bruins travel to Carolina Forest very soon, and I know that all of our players and coaches are excited about finally getting to put all their hard work into action. I'm proud of all of our student athletes, and I am looking forward to being out there supporting you this year at every opportunity. Certainly, you have noticed all of the new safety policies and procedures in place this year. I want to commend you on a fantastic start. The closer that we can all follow safety protocols, the better off we will be, the safer we will be, and the sooner we can all return to normal. Hopefully, we will have some outdoor seating for lunches very soon, and we are planning to open the vending machines during lunch for student use next week. So I ask you to just please use your best judgment with that. Don't forget, we're taking attendance every day for every student, whether you are a virtual or an in-person student. For our in-person students, your presence at school on your assigned cohort day counts as your attendance. For our in-person students on your at-home day, the submission of assignments by 4 p.m. will mark you as present. Beginning next week, all of your assignments for your personalized learning at-home day will be posted by your teachers by 8 a.m., giving you the entire day to work on and submit assignments. If you fail to submit some assignments by 4 o'clock, submit something from your work, you will be marked absent for each class period that you failed to submit some of your assignment. It does not have to be complete, but you have to have a submission. Even if the assignment isn't completely finished, your submission is evidence that you are working and will count as your presence in that class for that class period. Our virtual students, reminder that you have to log in every day at the start of class and remain logged in and active for the entire class period in order to be marked present. If you log in and then log out and do not participate in the class period, you will be marked absent for your virtual section. This is certainly a different kind of start for us all, but I'm confident that if we work together, put forth our best effort, that we will be successful this year.
Good morning, Bruins. Today I'm here to talk to you about breakfast and lunch and take-home bags. From this point forward, today until Christmas break, every student gets to eat for free in the cafeteria. You do not have to have your ID to come through and pick up a meal. You just come through, grab, and go. These are your take-home bags. I am located at the kiosk right below the stairwell by the main office at the end of every day. Please come by and grab a bag and take it home for your B day or A day schedule. Have a great day, Bruins.